Putting an animal to sleep may be the most difficult thing a pet owner will ever have to do, but sometimes it's necessary. When a pet is aging or ailing, a vet will offer owners their opinion on the animal's outlook and pain level. So rather than having the animal continue to suffer, they're given a dose of pentobarbital, a seizure medication that causes the heart and brain functions to shut down within minutes. But what happens when you euthanize an animal and it comes back to life minutes later? It sounds like a plot from Pet Sematary, but it actually happened. If you're iffy about things like fate, you might think twice after listening to this story. Someone was clearly watching over an adorable puppy named Rudolph back in January. The pup was living in an Oklahoma animal shelter, and his odds of finding a forever home were not looking good. Rudolph is only 7 months old, and his life was destined to come to a sad and lonely end. The shelter Rudolph was in was very overcrowded. The staff there made the tough decision of putting him to sleep. But the end of this puppy's life was really only the beginning. When an animal gets euthanized, they tend to stay down, and that didn't happen with Rudolph. Minutes after the vet administered the drugs that stopped his heart and brain, Rudolph came back to life. Staff members were stunned when they walked into the room and found the puppy was wagging his tail. The vet realized it wasn't Rudolph's time and refused to attempt to euthanize him again. The staff figured that there must have been a reason for Rudolph's resurrection, so they sent him to King's Harvest Pet Rescue No Kill Shelter in Davenport, Iowa, where he could continue to live his second chance. Once Rudolph's miraculous story came to light, the shelter received over 30 missed calls. They received a sea of adoption applications. People were lining up at the shelter's door and even braced the cold in order to see the sweet-faced pup in the hopes of becoming Rudolph's new owner. This was definitely a new experience for King's Harvest, who had never heard of a story like this. People drove far and wide for Rudolph. In fact, Jacob Hammer drove from Des Moines on a mission. He was hoping to give Rudolph a fellow combat veteran in Colorado who undoubtedly knew all about second chances. Hammer managed to gather $400 in donations for the possibility of making this happen. Then, moments after the news story aired on the local News 4 station, reporters announced that someone adopted Rudolph. We don't know whether it was Hammer or some other lucky person, but at least the pooch got a happy ending after all. Rudolph beat the odds and finally found his forever home. With the various applications King's Harvest Animal Shelter received, staff members like Rochelle Dugali, the shelter's assistant director, hope others will open their homes to other pooches in need. Rudolph's story was a gift for all the other dogs in desperate need of a home. This miraculous dog touched so many hearts that the shelter was able to clear a lot of their dog kennels through adoptions. If this amazing story doesn't inspire you to adopt, we don't know what will. Dogs residing at no-kill shelters across the country won't have to worry about euthanasia, but there are lots of dogs in shelters where it's the only option, but not because the pooches are sick or old. They're killed because of overcrowding, so please consider adopting a pet today.